If you want to play the same animation over and over again, why reinvent the wheel? Custom blocks are a way to reuse chunks of code and organize your blocks to make things more understandable. This makes them a powerful tool for story projects, allowing you to build up a library of different actions you can perform and execute, each one with a single block. New scratchers are often mystified by custom blocks, but the steps for creating them aren't as complicated as you might think. Start by isolating the chunk of code that you need to make your sprite perform a simple action. Test your action by clicking the stack of blocks to confirm it's doing what you expect. Now navigate over to the Custom Blocks area and click the Make a Block button. Give your custom block a name that describes the action you want to perform. Don't worry about the other options for now. Click OK to finish. You should now have a new red block on your screen that defines how your custom block will work. Attach your code underneath the defined block. Back in your code blocks tray, you should see a smaller red block that actually executes the function you just defined. Pull one out and click on it to test your action. Insert this block into your main code stack, and now you can use it as many times as you need. Custom blocks have a lot of added options that are only useful if you're making games and other more complicated projects. But one option you might want to check out is adding an input bubble. In this example, I've set up a loop that makes my robot clap a bunch of times. Let's create a custom block, but this time click on the input box to add an input. Call it number of claps. Now define your block. If you tug on the input portion, you'll create a little red bubble, which you can insert into your repeat loop. Now insert your new custom block into your code and type the number of claps you want to see. Now that's the power of automation.
I feel the liftoff. The clock has started. Roger.